What's up, YouTube? Today we're going to be talking about three of the biggest fat loss mistakes that I see as an online and in-person personal trainer working with average everyday people. Before we get into the video, I want to let you guys know that I do have some slots opening up for online coaching coming up next month. If that's something that sounds like it'd be of interest to you, you can drop an application down below. I'll leave a link in the description and I'll be in touch. Before we get into this, please drop a like down below. Please hit the subscribe button and bell notification icon so you can be notified when I drop future videos, as I'm going to be dropping a lot more videos and getting a lot more consistent. So make sure you're tuned in. Number one on the list, not tracking calories accurately. And what I mean by this is actually using a food scale. People have this huge faux pas, is that right? Faux pas, is that the right word? About using a food scale. They think that it's obsessive, they think that it's meticulous, they think it takes too much time. And here's the thing, if you wanna be accurate on this journey, and trust me, because the more accurate you are, the quicker this whole process is going to be. You can get out of a calorie deficit, reach your goals, get into maintenance, even build some muscle if you want to, because you don't need to be dieting all of the time. Using a food scale is going to help you get to your goals faster, and I cannot stress this enough. Weighing out your food in grams helps you be so much more accurate. It helps save you time, and it's just gonna make everything so much easier. You're gonna start seeing results on the scale. You're gonna start seeing results in your progress photos with your measurements. Everything's just gonna start falling into place once you just get rid of your pride and ego and preconceived notions that you have about tracking calories using a food scale. Bite the bullet and do it. I promise you it will make things so much easier and smoother in the future. You'll thank me later. Let's look at something like peanut butter, for example. Most people grab a tablespoon and they scoop out the peanut butter. Here's the problem with that. Most of the time the peanut butter is overflowing the tablespoon. You don't actually like level it off. Why? Because peanut butter is delicious. And why would you want less peanut butter? Which actually adds probably an extra 50 to 100 calories that you're not accounting for. Same thing with sauces, dressings, cooking oil. It's just all gonna add up and you're gonna save yourself hundreds and hundreds of calories per day. So track with a food scale. It will save you so much agony in the future. The second biggest fat loss mistake that I see is people starting their calories too low. We all know this magic number, 1200 calories. I don't know where the heck it came from, but it came about and people started using it frequently and they think that it's this magic number that helps you lose weight, especially with women. The problem with this is most of you need more than 1200 calories. You're gonna be starving and you're not gonna be able to be consistent on this number of calories. Sure, Monday through Friday or Monday through Thursday, you may be able to eat that little because you're busy and you can keep your mind off of food. But then Saturday, Sunday comes and you blow out your whole calorie budget for the week on pizza, hot dogs, cookies, ice cream, outings at restaurants. Really, really easy to overdo it and blow out that entire calorie deficit that you created being so perfect and eating 1200 calories during the week. If you wanna do something like this, make it more structured. Use a calorie cycling approach. And if you want me to make a future video about calorie cycling, I can do that. Drop a comment down below and maybe I'll make a video on that one. What fat loss is all about is eating as much calories as possible while still losing body fat. So if you are trying to eat 1200 calories and you plateau eating 1200 calories, what's gonna happen is you're gonna have to drop calories even lower and you're gonna be even more miserable. It's gonna take you longer. You're not gonna be consistent with it. You're gonna fall off and you're gonna give up. Now, quick disclaimer here, some people do need 1200 calories. If you're short, if you're a small person, you don't need as many calories as a bigger, taller person. Just thought I'd note that 1200 calories may be appropriate for some people, and even less than that may be appropriate for some people. We hear all these influencers saying, my toddler eats 1200 calories, you should eat way more than that. And here's the thing is, it's different for everyone. Some people's metabolisms are slower. Some people are genetically predisposed to burning less calories. It's just different for everyone. If you want to find out your starting calories, you can check out my free calorie calculator down below to find out a sustainable calorie deficit for yourself. The third and final fat loss mistake that people make is not eating enough protein. Now, when it comes to protein, guys, I boast the benefits of protein probably like 80% of my videos. So you guys should know already that protein is super important. Number one, it is the best macronutrient for keeping you full. When it comes to protein, if you're not using it to your advantage to stay full in a calorie deficit, then you are messing up. Most people try to eat like 60 grams of protein as like a 150 pound person, and it's just ridiculous. You're gonna be hungry, you're gonna have cravings, and you're not gonna be able to stick to your diet. So you might as well increase that protein. It'll reduce your cravings, it'll keep you full, and you'll make faster progress. Why? Because protein has the highest TEF, or thermic effect of food, which means that it takes a lot of energy for your body to break down protein and use it. And yes, this is a good thing, because only about 85% of the calories that you eat from protein are actually used by the body. The other 15% are burned through the process of trying to break it down. And last thing about protein is that it's gonna help you retain muscle while you lose fat. So what this means is you're gonna lose less muscle, you're gonna look leaner, you're gonna look more toned, you're gonna look better in the long run if you up that protein intake. So hopefully these tips were helpful, guys. If they were, please drop a like down below. Drop a comment down below as well and let me know if you want me to make videos on any particular topics, or if you have any questions, I always answer all of my comments. I love you guys, and I'll talk to you in the next video. Bye-bye.